Hello and welcome to another session of Simufact tutorials by Hyperlacium team. This video was made by Amin Ganjabi and narrated by Kushapur Ramadani. In this session, we are going to discuss stress relief heat treatment and how to define it in our project. The stress relief heat treatment allows the calculation of stress relaxation due to heat treatment. The idea behind this process type is to define a temperature history over time. For the stress relief process, we need to use the output from an already solved project. In this part, we first explain the output of the previous model and then explain the heat treatment model itself. To start with, right-click on the process panel and select copy from results, then click on OK. As you can see, the project's name is resistant spot welding. You can see the results by clicking on the results button in the process tree. The temperature contour will be displayed on the process window, and by clicking on the fast forward button below it, you can jump to the end of the process. You can also choose the parameter you want to be displayed. Currently, the temperature is being selected, but by hovering the mouse over to it here on the top left corner of the process window and clicking on it, a menu will open which you can choose from. For example, different types of stress, including effective stress, yield stress, or maximum principal stress are all listed here. Now, if you want to see the results for the equivalent elastic strain, you can simply find it under the strains heading, and the results will be shown on the process window when you click on it. If you right-click on the model and choose active selection mode at the bottom, a new window will open on the right side of the screen. And wherever you click on the model, its coordinates and respective equivalent elastic strain, which we have chosen, will be shown on it. It doesn't matter how many spots we click on, it will show them all and in the order we have chosen them. Now kindly right-click on the results and select history plot. In the open window, you can study the already defined nodes throughout the welding process. By clicking on the boxes in the selection tab, the respective graph will be shown on the plot window. For example, by clicking on clamping 5, its force graph in the Z direction over time will be shown on the left. You can choose which features to be shown along the X and Y axis in this section. When you have your desired plot, simply by clicking on export over here, you can save it under the CSV format. There is also another option to export your data. Go back to the process tree, right-click on the results and select UMV export from the list. In the open window, choose select all in the components tab and again in the increments and result values tabs. Then in the result values tab, first choose save to file and then click on export. Double-click on process 2 from the process tree panel and change the process type to stress relief heat treatment in the open window. Set the ambient temperature at 20 degrees Celsius. Check the gravity box and change the amount of Y to 0 and Z to minus 1 and then click on OK. As you can see on the left panel, an option called oven has been added. We need to define a heat treatment curve for it. FYI, the heat treatment curve is a temperature versus time plot and it is mandatory to define it for the process. Find the stress relief in the object catalog panel. Right-click on it and select new heat treatment. The menu on the left side is consisted of overview and stages. Overview allows you to select the stage you are going to calculate in addition to giving an overview of the time temperature plot. In the heating section under stages, set the duration to 60 seconds and change the ambient pressure from constant to table. You notice that the box next to it changes to this little diagram icon. Click on it. Next, hover over to the green add button and click on it once. Change the temperature unit to Celsius. Now change the temperatures in the beginning to 20 degrees and at the end to 950. Then click on OK. Now we have to do the same thing in holding and cooling sections. Set the duration to 60 seconds in both sections, but set the ambient temperature to 950 degrees Celsius only in the holding section. There is no need for changing the default amount in the cooling tab except for the duration, which is 60 seconds. Now select OK. You can see a new subset named Heat Treatment under the Stress Relief in the Objects Catalog panel. Drag and drop that into the oven in the adjacent Process Tree panel. Now double-click on Solver and increase the number of domains in the Parallelization section to 4 and decrease the number of cores to 2. Go to the Time Control section, set the analysis end time to 1800 seconds and check if the global friction value is set to 0.3. Then click on Apply and OK. Now we are ready to execute the model by clicking the green arrow below the process window. The process took me a day to solve and I skipped the processing time. On this screen, we have the results. First, I would like to show them to you. Here is the equivalent elastic strain. To evaluate the magnitude of the nodal results, I select some random points. As you can see, the one in the middle has the largest value. To wrap up, I would like to show you one more time how to export the results in an example. I use the UNV option, then I select the geometry, which is 1mm-3, then for the increment section, we are looking for the last one. Finally, we choose the results and hit the apply button. In this video, I tried to show how to simulate the heat treatment process in Simufact, and I hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more Simufact tutorials. And until the next time, I wish you the best.
This video was made by Amin Ganjabi. To find his contact information and updated resume, please visit our website at hyperlyceum.com. Amin is an expert in Simufact, Caesar, PDMS, and some other engineering software. To plan an online session and discuss industrial and academic projects, please use the provided email address under Amin's profile. The cost of projects vary depending on the complexity of the work and can be discussed in advance. We are looking forward to working with you.